Do not steal. Do not commit the sins or the acts of stealing from others. Do not commit the act of stealing. It can be people's joy. It can be people's wealth. It can be property. It can be land. It can be gold. It can be money. It can be whatever it is. Do not steal in the world, because when you do, Mahadev says, I will wait for you. I take pleasure because I am Lord of destruction. He says, when you come by me, you come straight forward. You come clean with me because I am Bam Bam Bola. And then you will chant, Hara Hara Hara. So you must be careful. Anjana Mata sits to pray, but she has pure love for Lord Shiva. So she will chant it out aloud. Hara 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 Mahadev. But if you're a person who lies and cheats and steals and lives an untruthful life, be scared to say that Mahadev. Narayan, you scared to say Bam Bam Bola because he coming behind you. Think about it. Mahadev, he looks at her and he says to Parvati Devi, she has to wait. And the mother says, but look at her love. Let us go, Mahadev. Come on, let's bless her. And Mahadev says, okay, let's go down. And when he goes down, he stands before the mother and he says, Ma, I will bless you today because you want a divine child. I'm satisfied with your love and your devotion. Pray so much and sincerely that when you pray, God is satisfied with your prayer. When you sit here tonight, and to all those who tuned in, wherever you're seated and you're worshiping God, have full faith in God. And when you sit to pray, pray with so much of love that God is satisfied with you. Pray with so much devotion that God is satisfied with you. You didn't come here to sit down and see who came. You didn't come to sit down and look at anybody and see, I wonder what they bring. I wonder what she have on. I wonder what he put on tonight. I wonder what he bring in tomorrow night. I wonder what and I wonder what. Get rid of all the wonders of your thoughts, because when you sit before God, he means business. Pray. Focus. In our message, Bhagwan Shiva is about to bless her. But listen. Samay ekta राजग बोले जल तल न भसे मधुर से बोले ओ नमः शिवाय ओ नमः शिवाय राजा का बोले जल तल नभ से मधुर से बोले ओ नमः शिवाय ओ नमः शिवाय ओ नमः शिवाय ओ नमः शिवाय वृंदावन में हरिलाल की पवन सुधा हनुमान की Something so beautiful tonight. Anjani Mata prays to Bhagwan Shiva. And Bhagwan Shiva says, Devi, it will be very soon now. He says, Devi, you go outside now. And you go by that particular tree. And I want you to pray. And every day, at a particular hour, he gives her now a notion. He says, Ma, every day you put out that hand at that particular hour. And you pray and you chant, Om Namaha Shivaya. And she will go every day ardently. Om Namaha Shivaya. Om Namaha Shivaya. Om Namaha Shivaya. And she will pray every day at that particular hour as given. When we are given instructions to follow in our scriptures, follow them. When we are given guidance as to follow in our scriptures, follow them. Let the scriptures guide us. But we come to a very tricky part. We are about to speak now of Anand Ramayana. Remember, there's Tulsi Ramayana, there's Valmiki Ramayana, Anand Sagar Ramayana. This is Anand Ramayana now. There's Hanumat Ramayana. What happens in this scripture? Very beautiful. It says, while Anjani Mata is praying, at that particular time, in the palace of Raja Dashrath, they're about to perform the Putra Kameshti Yajna. And while they're about to do the Yajna, it is said, along with all the family members, Raja Dashrath sits with his three wives. Now, this is a very beautiful topic I like to touch on. Because when I finish, people come and say, Baba, wait now, if he had three wives, oh God, understand now. Many people come to our cult and to our religion, our dharma, and we come back and we say, well, Baba, well, if the book had, well, what about me? And we're ready to go now to the extreme. Listen now. It is said, while in our scripture, we understand this part of it. Bhagwan Shri Ramachandra, the Lord, he had taken his avatar. But do you know how it took place? Raja Dashrath, he got married to Kaushalya Maya. When he got married to Kaushalya Maya, were there any children? Were there any children? Anybody try? No? Who tell you that? Anand Ramayana. This is not Tulsidas and Valmiki. When Raja Dashrath got married to Kausalya, they had a daughter. The daughter was named Shanta. You research it. Coming from Anand Sagar. Don't take Valmiki and say, Baba, I find that day. Don't take Tulsidas ji. Remember, every scripture will have each part of it from time and age. Anand Sagar Ramayana says that when Raja Dashrath got married to Kaushalya, they had a daughter by birth whose name was Shanta. But she had taken birth and she was born deformed. When that daughter was born deformed, Raja Dashrath was looking forward to have a son to rule the kingdom. But because this child was born deformed, for the name and the character and the safety of the kingdom, it is said Raja Dashrath, he went to his guru. And Guru Vashishta, he says, to save the chastity of the kingdom, we can't hand down the kingdom towards this daughter. No matter how you think of it, she's not even fit. She has been born handicapped. So we need to wed her off. We need to give her away. And it is said with the advice of the guru, Guru Vashishta, he allowed Raja Rupa Mudraha to become married to none other than this beautiful Shanta. It is said while the marriage took place, Sringarishi, he came forth. Listen to the names, and if you remember the names of holy sages, Sringarishi came forth and he adopted her. And he said to the world that I will allow her to learn how to pray. I will teach her how to do worship. I will teach her how to do prayer. When Raja Dashrath couldn't have a son to rule the kingdom and he had given away his daughter, at that point in time, he went to Kaushalya Maya and he says, Devi, we have bring forth a child in the world who has been born handicapped. She's been born deformed. As a king, I have a role and I have a duty to perform. I have a kingdom to take care of. Let's go to the Guru. So they went by Guru Vashishta, and Guru Vashishta says, listen, Dulahin, we must understand now. Both of you must come to an agreement and you must speak to one another. Have a proper understanding. Have proper communication. Work together. Because in order to have somebody to rule the kingdom, you cannot bring forth a child who will rule the kingdom. Your children may be deformed. I have someone in mind, but Dulahin, only with your permission we can allow this to take place. Raja Dashrath, he spoke to Kaushalya Maya privately, and after some time, Kaushalya Maya says, I can't bring forth a child. The child is not just for us, but it is for a kingdom, and the sacrifice must be made. Sometimes sacrifices must be made in your life to be accomplished, or to accomplish anything that you want. Sometimes if it means giving of your heart, giving of yourself, working hard in the world to become a better person, sacrifice is all that it takes. Nothing is handed down easy. And I always say these words. Anytime something is handed down easy, then easy come, easy go. You work hard for what you want. Put in effort in what you want. Whatever you want for in your life, work hard for it and it will last forever. It will last for a lifetime. But if you don't work for it, it will not stay in your hands. Hard work. Utta jaga musafir Bhoravai Abarena kaha Jo sovat hai Utta jaga musafir. Get up and start moving in the world. Do you know lazy people? Do you know any lazy people? Let me see, pop your hands. Don't put it up like this. Put it up straight. Bajarangabali ki! We are about to testify to the energy of Mahavir Swami. Have you ever seen in the entire epic of Ramayana, Mahavir Swami sit down and say, well, Lord, abode. You love hear that? He was always ready. Jai Shri Ram. Lord, what do you want to be done? Just say it. It says in our scripture, at this point, understand that we must get up and work for what we want. And if you don't work for it, it will never last. Raja Dashrath spoke to Kausalya Maya, and Kausalya Maya, she says, let's go with the words of Guru Vashishta. And Guru Vashishta says that there is one Devi by the name of Sumitra Maya. Let us seek her hand in marriage. And if you can unite and she can bring forth sons or a son that can control the entire palace, this is what we want, let's go with it. No problem. Let's go with the flow. So in accordance and agreement and understanding for the welfare of the entire community, the welfare of the kingdom, they had to come to this term. Otherwise, they would have to forfeit the entire kingdom. So they've decided to go ahead with it and to get up and act. Tonight, devotees, get up and act. Don't just sit there. When you hear the name of God being chanting, clap loudly. Don't be scared. Clap. Clear the energies around you. Sing the name of God as loud as you can and receive His darshan. Utta jaga musafir bhora bhai avarayana kaha jo sovata.
जो कल करना है आज कर ले।
Dashrath becomes wed to Kaushalya with the permission of Kaushalya Maya. He becomes wed to Sumitra. They're trying to bring a child in the world, but still they can't. So they've gone to Guru Vashishtha. And at this time now, there's a last person in mind. Guru Vashishtha says, go to that kingdom there. When you go to the kingdom, you will see a king who rules over that village. He has a daughter by the name of Kekayi. But you may have to make a compromise. I will go with you. And Guru Vashishtha walks alongside Raja Dashrath, Kausalya Maya, and Sumitra Maya. And they've gone to the palace now. They're asking for the hand of Kekayi in marriage. And while they're asking for the hand, who would look at somebody who wants to, or a king, who wants to become wed to your daughter, but he has come with two wives? He says, no. I won't allow this. Raja Dashrath already had two wives and he wants my daughter. No way. So you know what? Raja Dashrath pleads now. He says, Raja, I would like to take your hand or your daughter's hand in marriage. But I give you my promise. If children have been born from your daughter, I promise you her child will be the rightful king and owner of the kingdom. The king thought about it and he said, you know what? Okay. I am a king and I want the benefit and the best for my daughter. So I will give you my word. Raja Dashrath says, I promise you, as I have said, so it will be. And at that point, the marriage is about to take place with a promise and a commitment. You're listening to Anand Ramayan. You'll probably say, way we never hear it in our life. According to Anand Ramayan. So you see, if I don't give you the explanation, then when I finish the yagya and I come outside, somebody goes say, Baba, you say something there. You know, I want to find out something. You see them three wives you talk about there? And then the Baba in trouble. So this is the platform to clear it all, right? Anand Ramayan says, exactly as I've said it, with the permission of the first wife, Sumitra Mata, she becomes married to Raja Dashrath. Now with a promise to the father, Dashrath, Raja Dashrath says, he says, Raja, I give you a promise. If your daughter brings forth a child to my kingdom, I promise you that son will be the rightful heir to the throne. And then the king says, okay, I will seek the benefit of my daughter so you can become married to her. At the end of the day, he knows that her son will become a king. But time has passed and then no children have been born in the kingdom. So while time is passing, while Anjani Mata is praying on the outside, not too far away, the yagya has to be performed. Do you know something so special? Do you know who performed the yagya? Sringi Rishi. Do you know who came with Sringi Rishi to be a part of the yajna? the daughter. They sat down to perform Hawan Puja, and the yagya is about to begin, and they're making offerings into the fire, and they're praying to Agni Devta.
Om Tat Purushaya Vidmahe Vayu Putraya Dhimahi Tanno Vayu Prachodayat. Om Shri Anga 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 Agni Devtaya Namaha Pavak Namasya Shandal Gotra Varun Pita Arun Mata Shri Agne Namaha.
And the fire has been invoked and Agni Devta is present. And there they have invoked the energy of that divine and pure Devta, Agni Dev. And coming from the fire, who comes, my friends? It is said that Devta holding in the hand that sacred pot. And what is in the pot? Some say butter, some say curd, some, my friends, they say kheer. But that nectar, that kheer comes out of the fire and it is handed down to the mothers. And the mothers take the kheer and they start splitting now all together. And while they're splitting the kheer, they're about to partake. It is said Kausalya Maya, Sumitra Maya and Kekayi, they are partaking of the kheer. And while they're eating all together, scripture tells us that they are happy, they're contented, and they're waiting for the most appropriate moment.
Shri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama 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 Shri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama
It is said at this time now, while the mothers are partaking of their kheer, it is said at that point, one of the mothers, her tummy is feeling a little too filled. So she goes outside onto the veranda of the palace and she places it on top of the veranda. And while she places it there, she says, I can't make anymore. It is too much. It is too sweet. So she turns around and she goes to partake of some water. And when she goes to drink water, it is said Lord Indra above in the skies is looking down at the moment and he knows what he must do. So he calls upon Vayudev. He says, Vayu, it is now your responsibility to do what you must. So what does he do?
Parate na kohi priti kavava Parate na kohi priti kavava
So it is said at this time. At this time, Vayudev turns into a bird. And there he comes down and he sweeps down at the point in which he sees the keer, and he picks up some with his feet and he starts to travel with it now. And while he's traveling, this is the moment that the world has been waiting for. All together.
Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama. Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama. Shri Rama Jai Rama.
Everybody,
Shri Rama Jai Rama,
bolo,
Jaya.
Kya baat?
Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama. Shri Rama Jai Rama.
The keer has been placed on top of the windowsill. And there Vayudev transforms himself into a bird, and he sweeps down and he takes his feet and he grabs an amount of the keer, and he starts to travel now. And the mother, she's praying and she's waiting. She's praying and she's waiting at that point. And she's praying, Om Hara 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 Mahadev. When suddenly she feels onto the palm of her hand something that falls, and when she looks at it, it looks tasty, it smells good. And she says now, in that Vanara Roop, she takes it and she touches it to her mouth and she says, Hare, Mahadev told me look out for something, something will fall. I've been placing my hand here every day at this particular hour and something has fallen in my hands. So she starts to partake and she's eating it up, everything. And when she eats it up, time will pass now. The moment will pass, and when that time will come, the Lord will prepare to make his way. It is said in the kingdom of Raja Dashrata, Kausalyamaya, Sumitramaya, Kekayimaya, they're preparing, they're in a family way, and you're preparing to bring your child. But not only them, a mother in the depths of the forest, she sits down by herself. She's cuddled by Kesari, and they're waiting for the most opportune moment because a child is about to be born. And while the kingdom will celebrate Prabhu Ramachandra, Lakshmana, Bharata, Satrughna, it is that the mother sits there and a wonderful baby has been born, Vanar Roop. He's, my friends, it is said, incarnated form of Bhagwan Shankar, like the mother would have asked for. And he has taken his form. Nishtay prema pratitate vinay kare sanama. देही के काजल सकल सुभा श्री करे हनुमान वीर मारुते गंभीर मारुते वीर मारुते गंभीर मारुते महावीर स्वामी हस्ते कन्वर्ट. Of the other ways or the means of which Mahavira Swami has taken birth. But just to recap for a second, think about this. When the children were born in the kingdom, it is said, Kausalyamaya gave birth to whom? Kausalya gave birth to Sri Ramachandra. It is said, Sumitra gave birth to Lakshmana and Satrughna. And Kekayimaya gave birth to Bharata. The last, the mother KK gave birth to Bharata. In the Kahani, in Ramcharitmanas, we would have heard where KK Maya stood up and she said to Raja Dashrath, my son must be king. You cannot put Sri Ram to be king of Ayodhya. And if you must go against your word, I will have a problem. You must send away the Lord and keep your promise and put my son as the king. The mother was only standing up for the promise that she was given. She was only standing up for what she was told at the very beginning, because a promise was given to her that her son will be the rightful king. In the end, we look at the mother and we say, that what kind of mother will send his son in the forest for 14 years? But the mother was standing up for her right. Her son was Bharata, and she was given a promise that her son will be the king if she brings a child in the world. That was the only way she became married. Not so. Listen.
Bhidamarute.
It doesn't take reading one scripture to understand what we heard tonight. It doesn't take one time to look back at our message to understand what has taken place tonight. But read it again. Understand the philosophy. We must understand the sacred text all put together. At this point in time, another birth of the Lord. He was then, being that all of them had taken birth around the same time in. Now you could acknowledge that when Navratri is about to come just now, we'll have the Navratam, 9 days. And on the 9 day, we call the 9 day what? Shri Ram Navami. Because the birth of Shri Ram. And then a few days after the birth of Lord Hanuman. Because the Kheer was given at the same time and at the said moment. When the mother was given a few days after, the moment in which she was given the Kheer and she partook of it. Not too long after the birth of Mahavir Swami. So we understand that part of the scripture. Now that was one way, being that they were all born from the same Kheer, at some parts of our scripture, Hanumanji is known to be the brother of Sri Ramachandra. They've been born out of the same nectar that they partook of. According to Maharshi Purana, Bhagwan Shankar Bolinath, he sits in Kailash Parvat, and he says, Devi, you know very soon the manifested form of the Lord will be taken birth, not so. He says, do you know very soon Prabhu Vishnu is about to take avatar? And when Bhagwan Vishnu decides to take avatar and he goes to the earth, Ma, I am so in love with the form of Lord Vishnu. I want to be a part of that. I want to be a part of it. How many people wish to be a part of this yatra? How many people wish to be a part? Do you know how many people have been calling me and saying, Baba, you know what? Which part? Tell me now, God, please. Tell me now, we'll just come one night. But then we must adhere to the rules and restrictions of the COVID. So to all those who are tuned in, we are sending our vibrations and our blessings to you wherever you are. But we must still adhere to the restrictions of the COVID. Do you know how many people wish to be here? Do you know how many people wish to be a part of satsang and yajna and a part of worship? Many are called and few are chosen. And even if you are not here personally or physically, you can also view us and receive that vibration. Today, Bhagwan Shiva says, don't you know how much I want to be a part of being in the company of the Divine Lord, the Incarnation? And the mother says, okay, if you want to go down to be a part of worship with Bhagwan Vishnu, you can't go by yourself. I come in with you too. He says, but Hare Maya, but I'm in love with the Lord's incarnated form. What will you do? I want to come with you too. There's a saying that the Dulahin must always accompany the me Ravan boy. Dulhin was a company who? Jai Narayan. Them Dulhadu so. The Dulhin was a company, the Dulaha. Listen, my dear friends. While Bhagwan Shiva wants to worship Bhagwan Vishnu, listen. Hare Krishna. Hare. Krishna Krishna Hari Hari Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hari Hari Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hari Hari Hare Hare, Radhe Govinda, It is at this point where Bhagwan Shiva is about to take his incarnation and is about to come to the earth. But he must disguise himself. So he says, Devi, I will take Vanara Roop. I will go to the earth, but into the form of a Vanara Bandar, a monkey. And she says, but Prabhu, I will be your strength. I will be your Shakti. I will be your protective power. And I will go down with you. Lord, when you go as that monkey, that Vanar, I will reside on your tail. And while I reside on your tail, remember and know that anytime you need strength and Shakti, I will be there. I will be there to protect you. As long as you're, as much as you're there and you're Mahadev, you will need my inner strength and my power. Receive vibrations of our Lord. Yajapi samadhi shubhidira pipashati natava nagara marichi. Yajapi samadhi shubhidira pipashati natava nagara marichi. Iramichami nishamyatava chuta karpikriparbhuta vichi. Iramichami tava chuta tarpe kripar bhuta veche krishna deva bhavantam vande krishna deva bhavantam vande mana manasa madhukara marpaya pada nija pankaja makarande mana manasa madhukara Padaneja Pankaja Makarande Krishna Deva Bhavantam Vande 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 Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Sabko? Krishna. Kya baat? Hare Rama. Ek baar aur sabko pyari pyar se. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, 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 Hare, Hare, Rama, Rama, Hare, Hare, Rama, Rama, Hare, वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय बजरंग बली की डिवोटीज ऑफ गॉड इट इज सेड दैट पार्वती माता आदि शक्ति दुर्गा देवी शी सेज महादेव इफ यू गो डाउन टू द अर्थ एंड यू विल बी दैट वानर रूप आई विल बी ऑन योर टेल आई विल रिमेंबर आई विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड अपॉन दैट टेल ऑफ योर्स एंड आई विल बी योर स्पार्क एंड योर एनर्जी एंड योर स्ट्रेंथ व्हेनेवर यू नीड मी आई विल बी देयर When devotees worship Mahavira Swami, we must always remember to say our prayer to Devi Mata when we are worshipping him, and always put a little offering on the tail as well. In some of the pictures or some of the murtis, I don't think I saw any here. In some of the pictures or some of the murtis, you will even see a bell on the tail, hanging from the tail. That is to symbolize the calling of Divine Mata, the Shakti Maya. It is said the mother will always be present as long as Mahavira Swami is there. So think about it. When you're worshipping Lord Hanumanji, you can't forget Devi Mata. Her worship is also important. Her prayer is also important. Her love, devotion to her is always important. While this is one of the other forms of manifestation of the Lord has taken 8 different versions, 8 different avatars, or the 8 different ways of coming into the world. It is said in the month of Chaitra, on that full moon month, that full moon period of Chaitra, which is in the month of March, April, the Lord celebrates one birthday. It is said, secondly, in Chaitra Shukla Ekadasi, the 11th day of the bright fortnight of Chaitra, again, there's another birthday of the Lord. It is said, thirdly, in Kartika Purnima, the month of October, November, another appearance of the Lord. 3. Fourth, in Kartik Amavasya, at the new moon time in the month of Kartik, October, November, there's another birth of the Lord. 5. In Shravana Shukla Ekadasi, the 11th day in the month of Shravana, which is in July, August, another birth of the Lord. Hanumanji. Shravana Purnima, or the full moon day of Shravana, another birth of the Lord. Mrigashirsha Shukla Trayodashi, the 13th day in the month of November or December, according to the stars fall, another birth of Lord Hanumanji. And 8. Ashwin Amavasya, the new moon in the month of September, October, another birth of Lord Hanumanji. Hanumanji has 8 birthdays. Jai Bhagwan. And with all these different birthdays or different intervals of his birth, the Lord has taken avatar. And it is so coincidentally that all of these will fall either on a Tuesday or either on a Saturday. Those are the days of his worship. Who rules on a Tuesday and who rules on a Saturday? Tuesday is ruled by? In Hindi, Tuesday is called what? To those who are sitting at their home, they could go on Google Devta now fast. They could search it up. In Hindi, Tuesday is called Mangalvar. Who rules on a Tuesday? Mangal Devta, one of the planets of the nakshatras, one of the planets of the Navgraha, Mangal Devta. On a Saturday is ruled by who? It is called what? What day is it in Hindi? I know that one real good boy. Like a little Harel Shani granting. Shanivar. So many people say, well, Baba, every time we check for gravel, we had a fast on a Saturday, right? Shani. Yeah, we know about Shani, man. Shanivar rules. Shani rules on that day. And it's so coincidentally that his birthday falls in that time, either Tuesday or on a Saturday. And because he's mighty and powerful, and because he holds what? He holds what? We call this? Jai Bhagwan. Because he holds the gada, it is said Mangalvar, he fears Mahavira Swami. He says, well, you take charge of the day. I will rule, but you take charge. If anybody call your name, I go on. On a Saturday, it is said Shanidev rules the day, and Shanidev says, if you even look at me, I will cast negativity into your life. But if you call Hanuman Baba name, well, I go on too. Look at the power of Mahavira Swami. Later in the yatra, you will hear the kahanis as to what evolves from the kahanis of our Lord in terms of Shanidev and Mahavir, Mangal Dev and Mahavira Swami. But tonight, it is said, while the birth of our Lord has taken 8 forms, remember tonight, my dear bhaktas, Ashta Siddhi Nava Nidhi Ketata Asbaradina Janaki Mata. Power Sutta Hanuman ki. Lord Hanumanji, as a child, loves his mother. Who as a child doesn't love his mother? Well, Anjani Mata, in order to be given the boon of becoming the mother of Lord Hanumanji, tomorrow night we will hear of her history in becoming that blessed mother ardent devotee to be born as Anjani Mata. And then we'll hear now of the childhood days of Lord Hanumanji. Pauna Sutta Hanuman ki jai. At this time, let us all stand now as we've concluded our message and we now go into beautiful arati.
आरती की जय हनुमान लला की दुषदल नर गुनाथ करा के आरती की जय हनुमान लला की दुषदल नर गुनाथ करा
so some of the devotees who wish to come and perform your arati you can do so
जाके बल से गिरिवर दोष जाके निकट न जाके अंजनी 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 पुत्र महावर जाये सदन के प्रभु सदा सदाए देवी रा रघुनाथ पटाए लंका
chant his name while we glorify Mahavir Swami remember to say a prayer in your heart in your mind and Lord is part of this beautiful yatra glorification to you
arati ki jai hanuman lala ki vishadala naragona आरती की जय हनुमान लला की विशदल रघुनाथ कला की जय 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 हनुमान जय 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 हनुमान
As we glorify Bajranga Bali, we sing along with love. We sing with all devotion. Ram Siya Ram, Jai Ram Siya Ram. Ram Siya Ram, Jai Ram Siya Ram. Ram Siya Ram, Jai Ram Siya Ram. हनुमते नमः ओम नमो 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 हनुमते नमः हनुमान की बजरंग बली की बजरंग बली की जय जय सीताराम आसने जी अर सौते कर सीट्स अस वी टेक आवर सीट्स अस वी प्रे वंस मोर टू द डिवाइन लॉर्ड मे द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ लॉर्ड हनुमान जी बी विद ईच एंड एवरीवन एंड अंटिल वी कंटिन्यू आवर ब्यूटीफुल यात्रा टुमारो नाइट ओम श्री हनुमते नमः टू ऑल दोस हु ट्यून इन वी विल बी लाइव फ्रॉम 3 to 5 p.m. टुमारो सो ऑल द डिवोटीज कैन जॉइन विद अस जय हनुमान।